After 10 grueling months, the 2011 race to Woodford is nearing its conclusion in dramatic style. With just the flagship event of the tour left to play, the standings in the Race to Woodford leaderboard look like this. Fish already has one hand on the trophy, knowing that just a point scored today will guarantee him victory. And with Biscuit absent from the field, there's a slim chance of Burns claiming the title, and he would have to rely on Fish not coming second. The only other piece of silverware realistically up for grabs on the final day of the season would be the Nearest the Pin title, in which Burns currently leads the standings. But with Nearest the Pin not until the 18th hole at Woodford, there will be a lot of golf to play before that was decided. These are the players in the field then for the final day of the season. Good to see representatives from all four houses. The players teed off as a 5-ball from the first. It was an inauspicious start from Seve at the opening par 4. But at least his ball was still in play. Fish stepped up looking relaxed and confident, iron in hand for safety, and he duly found the middle of the fairway. Up next was Burns, looking to play conservative with the short wood. And an easy swing found him in A1 position without too much trouble. Next it was the turn of Schoolhouse to lay down an early marker. It wasn't pretty from Springett, but it got the job done. Ballinger was unaffected by what had gone before him though, crunching his first drive straight down the middle.
Oh, that's the shot of the day so far.
It was fun and games at the second green after a collection of atrocious tee shots. And while Seve and Sproggett searched for their mishit approaches, Ballinger struggled to find his touch. Burns had zigzagged his way down to the green and had this for a bogey, coming up just short and tapping in for a point. Ballinger was playing his fifth shot into the eighth green, although receiving two strokes from his handicap, points were very much still on the cards here. Burns and Sproggett have both already blocked the hole, the latter choosing to play on to try and find his elusive form. Ballinger was the man still in active competition though, and he had to sink this for a point, which he did very comfortably. After the turn, Sproggett was looking to banish the demons of a bad start, and despite putting his third shot into the trees, he managed to chip out and recover to score a 1-point double bogey. While the front group struggled up the 13th fairway, the scores through 12 holes were like this. Burns was clinging on to a 1-point lead over Fish, with Seve and Ballinger just behind, Sproggett meanwhile having a terrible day there, languishing on 6 points. Over the following holes, Sproggett and Burns would share in the misery of a very barren run. While Ballinger, Seve and Fish quietly set about building themselves a good score. The North House man making no mistake at the par 5 15th, holding this for a point. Meanwhile, all the big action was happening back in the pairing of Seve and Fish, Seve stringing together some wonderful holes to edge himself into the lead through 16. This drive down the middle at 17 did Fish no harm, and Burns slipping down the rankings was mirrored only by Ballinger moving up. Sproggett meanwhile failed to add to his earlier tally. At the 18th, Fish would need a hole in one if he had any chance of clawing back Seve's 4-point lead. And they don't come much closer than that. If we check the replay, we can just see that the ball does indeed lip out of the hole right at the death. So alas, no hole in one for Fish. You'd have to be satisfied with Nearest the Pin. That left Seve with 3 putts then to tie up the event. He needed just 2 to take his first victory on the OBA Tour. It was a comfortable victory by 3 points over Fish for Seve, who will be delighted to have finished the season on a high. He also picked up longest drive for his troubles. While over in the Roger Goldie Challenge, there were no movements of note to prevent Fish from claiming the title. Confirmation of Fish's victory there by a stroke over his West House teammate Biscuit. He also scored the longest drive win for the season, but unfortunately for him, missed out on the Grand Slam by losing nearest the pin to Burns in a playoff. Fish does, however, claim the big one and is the 2011 Race to Woodford champion, his score of 11 points giving him clear daylight from Biscuit and Burns, who trailed on 8. So that's it for another year, but don't worry, we'll be back in January with an exciting brand new season of golf for you. See you then.
Burnsy, go a bit closer to Fish.
Can you get hands? You got us?
Perfect.
All right. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
1-0. 1-0.
1, 2, 3.
Yes!
Oh, it's all over.